Dear students, today we will study about legal and ethical issues and role of nurse in genetic counseling. Now, what are the major issues and ethical issues in genetic counseling? The main thing is that it is a new branch which has arisen and not all have equal access to the services. Major issues are equitable access is not there to, this service is not there to the whole population. Then is voluntary or mandatory counseling. Voluntary, my patients will do according to their own wish, or it is mandatory, compulsory. This is another issue. Then what about testing and screening? Where it will be done? Individual and parent choices to be safeguarded. Full disclosure of confidentiality, that is very important part, that has to be preserved at any cost. Now, confidentiality about information means it should be, the thing should be totally secret. The confidentiality of the patient and whatever they are planning should not go out anywhere. If that trust the patient won't develop, they will not come for this thing. Privacy of genetic information from institution and third parties, because this test will be done outside, that information should be kept totally screened, totally in secretive way. Is it directive or non-directive counseling? The non-medical use of prenatal diagnosis. Prenatal diagnosis only under the medical instructions only it should be done. Without that, it should not be. What about research and gene therapy? How much research is being done in this area, and what is the success of this? These are some of the major questions which are coming around because it's a new branch. So this is considered to be the main issues. Now, what is the uniqueness of this medical genetics? It may affect the entire family. It may be predictive. We can put, because it is running from family to family, from generation to generation. So it is predictive. We can predict it that if a child is born in the previous families, it is there, means this family is also going to have it. The child who will be born will is a chance that the child will have that illness. It may affect future generation. Of course, if not corrected, it will pass on. It has a tradition of non-directiveness in counseling. Then the general principles which should be followed. The general principles, ethical principles, is first is autonomy. Autonomy means the patient, we should never force anything on the client. The patient, we have to explain them everything, the positives and negatives and everything about that, about the genetic testing, about what is the prognosis, everything we should explain, but decision taking should be theirs. That is autonomy. They have the freedom to take the decision. That is first principle is autonomy. Second is beneficence, means patient should receive highest priority in benefits. The patient should be at the beneficial end. They should not be kept in dark. Because nowadays trend is that everything is become professional and people to make money. They say anything, they trap them and do that. So patient should receive highest priority and about everything should be told openly to them. Non-maleficence. Patient should not be prevented from any kinds of harm. They should not be hurted in any way. Then justice should be fair, done with the patient. Like benefits and burdens of healthcare should be distributed fairly, like charging them, because nothing is free of cost, and of course genetic testing will be on a higher side. So with justice point only we should charge the patient, and whatever treatment is dealing with them, everything should be done in a fair way. Informed consent, without taking consent from them. Written documented consent should be there before doing the genetic counseling or genetic testing or any treatment, gene therapy or anything. Before doing that, written consent should be taken from the patient. Patient should be informed about the what is the aim of that method, what selection criteria will be used, what will be the benefits, what is the risk involved in that. Everything should be very clearly in written informed to them. Then confidentiality. Patient has the right to full confidentiality. Next is ethical principles applied to genetics. That's again parental autonomy during abortion cases. Parental autonomy should never force them. Suppose the child is having some we are diagnosing inside the womb itself that the patient is having a congenital anencephaly or hydrocephalus or neural tube effects or heart disease or esophageal atresia, any kind of congenital diseases they may be having, but we should never force, we should explain them the pros and cons, but autonomy decision will be there, we should never force them. Then non-directive consultation. Practitioners need to disclose to the consultee the risk and benefits of each procedure. That risk and benefits of each procedure should be explained to them before each procedure. Then in case of putative father, not the biological father, in case the father is not the biological father, but we are taking a father in rent, like the sperm will be collecting, or the somebody would have adopted the child, in that case the mother should be informed about everything, because the father is sperm production, they are not having children, and the sperm count is nil in case of the father. Even after all the treatments they are not able to overcome that. In that case what the thing is, you will take we will be taking sperms from other person, but all the informations should be given very clearly. All the information should be very clearly told to the family. Nothing should be hidden. The mother should be told, because no mother will be able to accept that thing. So confidentiality is very important, and their mother should be prepared for accepting that. Without the mother's consent, that should not be done. So she should be informed. And this should be done to avoid all the social problems and psychological problems which will occur in future. Then in case this, what is the role of nurse? Recognize and suspect genetic disorders by their physical characteristic and clinical manifestations. In genetic counseling, only the persons who have taken training in that, they only can do that, because it's a very sensitive branch, and hence during the training period the nurses will be taught everything, and those who can recognize and suspect genetic disorders by the physical characteristics and clinical manifest, they should be able to recognize and suspect. Then create a genetic pedigree, that is diagram of the family history of nearly about from the third 3 to 4 generations. It should be, that pedigree should be, the family tree should be drawn, including birth, death and genetically linked element. Then clear up misconceptions and allay of feeling of guilt. All these things should be cleared. Assess the diagnostic process by exploring medical and family history information by using physical assessment skills, blood samples. This should be done by the nurse. All diagnostic procedures by exploring medical and family history and by using physical assessment skills and blood samples, all should be taken. Enhance and reinforce self-image and self-worth of parents and child with genetic condition. They should improve, they should encourage, they should value their self-image, because persons having malformations or congenital anomalies, they will be having, or always they will be having a self-pity feeling. So we should enhance and reinforce self-image and self-worth of parents and child with genetic condition. Encourage interaction with family, friends and other referrals. Phone numbers of support group. Refer and prepare for genetic counseling. Remain non-judgmental. We should never judge them. Coordinate, because they will be in different type of emotional trauma. Their emotional condition will be we cannot understand that, which we will not be knowing that, so we should never judge. Maybe when they may be in plenty of emotional trauma, they may behave in different ways, so we should not be judgmental, because we cannot predict everything by that. Coordinate genetics related health care with relevant community and national support system. With relevant community and national support system, we should coordinate genetics. So this was, and then the nurses, they are the key person who will be the geneticist or the doctors or the technicians will be doing, or the therapist, they will not be with the patient for a longer time. The maximum time is the nurse who will be with them. So we should always have a smiling face. We should always be accepting them, and we should be always ready to clarify their doubts, and we should tell them all the negatives and positives of that, and always have a warmth for them, empathy feeling for them. So this is all about the role of nurse. Thank you. Hope you have understood. Do listen carefully, prepare notes, and give the feedback. Thank you.